Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam's death. How do you think the Sahaba felt when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam died? What do you think that they went through? When a member of our family dies, how do we feel? The closer the member, the more we feel. Some of us don't even know whether it's day or night. This is how sad we are. And it is only natural to be sad at the time of death and at the loss of one's close ones. How do you think the Sahaba felt when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam died? Because this was not the death of an ordinary man. It was the death of the best of creation. It was the death of that person. Okay, they could not even tolerate separation from him, not even for a second. The one they loved more than themselves, their family, their children, everything. One comes and he says, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inni laqitu al-adu wa laqitu abi fihim, fa sami'tu laka minhum maqalatan qabiha, fa lam asbir hatta ta'anduhu bir'um." Ya Rasulullah, my father just came. He was with the enemy. He dishonored you. I couldn't tolerate this. I severed his head from his body. A second comes. She's carrying her child in sheets of cloth. It is at the time of jihad. And she comes to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, Ya Rasulullah, I know this son of mine, it cannot fight. I know it cannot make jihad. I know it cannot carry a sword. But Ya Rasulullah, take this son of mine and use him as a shield. Whenever the kuffar come from the right, hold my son in the way. And when they come from the left, hold my son in the way. A third comes and he stands before Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The kuffar attacking Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The words are flowing from this sahabi, "La yusibuka sahmun nahri duna nahrik," and he is taking the arrows and he is taking the swords on his hands and his chest. A fourth comes, "Ya Rasulullah, innaka la habbu alayka min nafsi wa innaka la habbu alayya min waladi wa inni la akunu fil bayti fa azkuruk fama asbir hatta adi fa anzur alayk." Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you are more dear to me than my soul. You are more dear to me than my family and children. When I am at home and I think of you, I become restless till I come and see you. I know one day you are going to die. I know one day I'm going to die. And I know, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when you die, such is your exalted status that you will be with the Anbiya. Ya Rasulullah, what will happen of this fakir? This fakir fears that when he enters Jannah, he will not be able to see you. Ya Rasulullah, just the thought of this separation distresses me. It was, as a witnessed, as he says, "Wallahi in ra'aytu malikan qattu yu'azzimu ashabu ma yu'azzimu ashabu Muhammadin Muhammada." That never has he witnessed a people so devoted to their master as he witnessed the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, bearing this in mind, I want you to tell me, how do you think that these people felt when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam left this world? This is why, when we pick up the books of Ahadith and the books on Sirah and Tariq, we find Hazrat Uthman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu is motionless. There is no harakat whatsoever. There is no movement. He does not know what has happened. Hazrat Ali there and then falls unconscious. One of the Sahabi, when he finds out, he raises his hand, a Bedouin. "Okay, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Allah, these eyes were so I could see your blessed Nabi, and these ears were so I could hear his blessed voice. When he remains no more, what do I want these eyes and ears for?" His prayer is answered. There and then he becomes blind. Fatima is saying, "Ya Abata, Ajaba Rabban Da'a, Ya Abata, Ila Jibrail Nan'a, Ya Abata, Min Jannatil Firdausi Na'wa." The general Sahaba are saying, "Wallahi wadidna anna mitna qabla." Only if Allah had not shown us this day, only if we had died before this. This was the general situation of the Muslims. Now look at the situation of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an. This is Abu Bakr. When this is happening all around him, and this event has torn the Sahaba, and they have lost their patience and their tolerance, he comes. It is the last day. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him to lead the prayer. He has led the believers in prayer. And then he comes, and he takes permission from Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He takes leave for a short while. He makes his way to his home in Sunq and he fulfills the need of his family. And then as he is returning, he hears the news, "Ka inna Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam qad mat," that the Messenger of Allah is no more. Saddened, tears begin to flow from his eyes. And the words that are flowing are, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un," that we all belong to the Almighty Allah. And to the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will return. He makes haste. He hastens. Only to realize that this news and this event has done damage and it has tore the Sahaba apart to such an extent that the one that they considered the strongest amongst them, the one from whom even the devil would run away. He is standing with a sword in his hand, and he is saying that the hypocrites claim that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam has died. Wallahi ma mat, by Allah he has not died. Walakinahu dhahaba ila rabbih kama dhahaba Musa ibn Imran, but he has gone to meet his Lord, just like Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam went. And the Messenger of Allah will return, and he will cut the hands and the feet of those people that are making these claims. By Allah, if Umar hears anyone saying that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam has died, Umar will sever their heads from their body. Umar will kill them. Now, if this was the situation of the strongest from amongst them, what do you think was the situation of the general Sahaba and those that had soft hearts and those that were considered weak from amongst the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in? Intellect, Akhil says that if in this situation the likes of Abu Bakr broke down, it would have been justified. Why? Because he was the one that was loved by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam the most. When he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, "Ayyun nas ahabbu ilayk?" The words that flowed were that I love Abu Bakr the most. He loved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam the most. He was the one that was with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam in childhood. He was the one that was the first to believe in Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the one that embraced him and that accepted him when all others rejected him. He was the one whose house Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam would visit every morning, every evening. He was the one who Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam would consult. He was the one that stayed with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam in every delicate moment. He was with him in Uhud, he was with him in Badr, he was with him in Khandaq. You name it, he was with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If in a situation like this Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu broke down, it would be justified. But look at Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He comes, he takes permission from his daughter Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. He enters her house. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is lying in one corner, covered with cloth. He comes and he uncovers the cloth and he kneels down and he begins to kiss the blessed face of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam with tears flowing from his eyes. And then he says, "Laysa ma yaqulu Ibn al-Khattabi shay'a tawaffiya Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam." What Ibn al-Khattabi is saying is wrong. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam has left the world. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam has died. Rahmatullah alayka ya Rasulullah ma atibuka hayyan wa mayyita. Allah's blessings be upon you, O Messenger of Allah. Saying this, looking at the delicate situation and looking at the Sahaba and the Muslims, he leaves and he makes his way to the masjid and he delivers a sermon to strengthen the Muslims and to console them and to bring them back. And he tells the Sahaba, "Oh my companions, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam had informed you that he was going to leave this world. Allah had informed you that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam was to die. When Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive, whilst he was amongst you, Allah also told you that you are also to die. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not say, 'Wa ma Muhammadun illa rasul qad khalat min qablihi ar-rusul afa'in mata aw qutila inqalabtum ala aqabikum wa man yanqalib ala aqibay falan yadurullahu shay'a wa sayazi Allahu shakirin innaka mayyitun wa innahum mayyitun.' You are to die. They are to die. Kullu man alayya fan wa yabka wajhu rabbika dhul jalali wal ikram. Everything will come to an end. Only your Lord will remain. Kullu nafsin dha'ikatul maut. Every soul will taste death. Oh people, whoever worship the Almighty Allah, fa inna Allah hayyun la ya'lik. The Almighty Allah is alive. La yamut. The Almighty Allah does not die. Whoever took Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as his Lord, then Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam remains no more. Fear the Almighty Allah and grab hold of your deen. It is only after this sermon do the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in come around to the extent that the likes of Umar, when he, Abu Bakr, recited the verse of the Quran, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ unto him, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, it was like as if this verse of the Quran had not been revealed prior to this. And so many